Session 11 of Module 1 of Fundamentals of Financial Management of 4th Semester BB of Mangalore University. In this session, we shall study about time value of money. Time value of money refers to that money available at the present time which is worth more than the same amount in the future date to its potential earning capacity. The time value of money describes the greater benefit of receiving money now rather than later. Money received in future is not valuable as money received today. So, present value or worth of money, 100 rupees received today is more valuable than 100 rupees received after a year. For instance, if a person is given the option to receive a fixed amount of money at either of the two time periods, then the person will prefer to receive at the earliest because the value of the current receipt of money is higher than the future receipt of money. This phenomena is also called as preference for money, that is the time preference for money. So, the benefit of receiving money today significance or importance of time value of money. The future is always uncertain and it involves risk. An individual can never be certain of getting cash inflow in future and hence he will like to receive the money today instead of waiting for the future. Individuals generally prefer current consumption. So, preference is given for the current present consumption. An investor can profitably employ the money received today. The rupee received today to get a higher value to be received tomorrow or after a certain period. If you have rupees 100 today, you can deposit that money in the bank account and earn interest for that amount. At some percentage, maybe 8% or 9%. So, after 1 year, today if you have 100 rupees, after 1 year you will get 108 rupees. But if the same amount you receive after 1 year without any interest, then that 100 rupees remains as 100 rupees only. In inflationary economy, when the price increases, the money received today has more purchasing power because during inflationary condition, the money doesn't have the purchasing power. So, in future, the value is not worth as it is in the present. Next topic is financial forecasting. Financial forecasting implies the technique of determining in advance the requirement and the utilization of funds for a future period. So, for a future, we are predicting now. So, from where we can get the funds, how we can utilize the funds. It is a technique of systematic presentation of data in the form of financial statements and ratios, calculating the ratios, etc. The importance of financial forecasting. It is immense utility. It has immense utility for the business organization on account of the following reasons. Financial forecasting generates useful information for financial decision making. It provides significant information for financial planning. It facilitates the firm to plan for the growth and the financial needs of the firm. It functions as a control device by providing a standard of financial performance for the future. It makes the firm to adopt appropriate financial policies. It enables the firm to make optimal utilization of funds, that is, nor minimum nor maximum, the exact utilization of funds to get the maximum returns. Risk-return trade-off. Risk may be defined as the chance of future loss that can be foreseen. In the case of risk, an estimate can be made about the degree of the happening of the loss. Return on investment must refer to the particular period of time. The return may be positive or negative. References.